Hello and welcome. My name is Carsten Lützen. I'm a Scrum Master and Agile Coach. This exercise that we're going to look at today is, I've decided to call it picnic planning. It can also be called yes and. It can have many different names. I use it in different situations. One situation is where I'm trying to learn others about facilitation. How can we acknowledge what people is sharing, and how can we make sure that we create an open atmosphere? We can also use this exercise to show the power of being curious and stuff like that. It is quite simple. It might create a bit of stressful atmosphere or bad feelings in the beginning, but it all serves a point. First off, I will break people into groups of two or three, just to have it small enough so everybody has some airtime, so to say. And the overall goal is you need to plan a picnic. And this plan a picnic, I deliberately do not specify what do I mean. I just say plan a picnic. That will lead to some confusion and some questions, but I'll try just to ignore those for the moment and say, next up, you have to reply no, but. So let's say that my idea is let's plan a picnic, and I think we should take a picnic into the forest. We should go on a picnic in the forest. Then the other person will say no, but we should instead go to the mall. And then we do that for, let's say, 2 or 3 minutes. Because as you might guess already, this is not very productive and people will start to become really annoyed because whatever they say, it's just no, it's just closed down right at the start. And also this, what do we really mean about this plan a picnic? Then in plenum, debrief, so what did you experience, any reflections, how did it feel, did it give energy, did it remove energy from you, so how, what happened in this small breakout room? And then as a fourth step, everything has to reply with yes and. So I think we should make a picnic to the beach. Yes, and then we could bring something to drink. Oh, yes, and just give people, again, 3 to 5 minutes. And then debrief. So, what happened? How did it feel? Did it give you energy? Did it remove energy from you? And hopefully at least people will have a lot more energy in this part because everything is acknowledged and being encouraged that yes, and then we can do this. So everything is treated like a good idea. Whereas here, everything is just being put down as soon as it's as soon as the sentence has finished. And that gives us to this sixth step, which is kind of the conclusion. And the important thing to stress here, I know this looks like a D, sorry. The important thing to know is when do I exhibit this behavior and when do I use this behavior? I'm not saying this behavior is never useful, but it's often not the best way of approaching things. This is often better. So people feel acknowledged, they feel heard, and they feel seen. Even though if we don't agree with what they have been what they have said, if we just say no, we force them into a defensive position. Always, almost always, use this yes and then build upon what is being said. I really like this approach. It's super, super awesome, and it's a great way of showing this to workshop participants or scrum masters or team members, that it really matters how are we replying, even just these automatic replies that we're sometimes giving. So I'm hoping that some of you will share how are you doing something similar like this to show the difference in how are we actually communicating and replying to questions and ideas in a team. And that's it for me. As always, comments, questions, ideas, and feedback is more than welcome. And then have a super, super awesome day.